You didn't say good day. All hollers, I'm a county fan. Yeah, money, money, I couldn't enjoy a class. It's your boy, your dig, 4 Eyes, 2 G's, and today we're here to talk about Lover's Rage 2 and how it will play into the storyline of Lil Uzi Vert's career. Ever since the likes of 21 Savage, Kodak Black, and Made in Tokyo have really translated to the mainstream, there have been two frontrunners of this generation, Lil Uzi Vert and Lil Yachty. And the way that these two artists were able to connect to the youth, mainstream, and stir up conversation about themselves was unparalleled. And since we've seen both of them blow up and become these huge names within the hip-hop culture, neither of them have become the indefinite number one. However, I think this is a major storyline for Lover's Rage 2, and once the album is released and we assess it, I think we will finally have a solidified leader of the new generation, Lil Uzi Vert. But why do I think this? Well, enough talking and let's dive right in. Also guys, make sure to follow your boy on all social medias, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Also make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications if you haven't, but let's get it. Firstly, we need to talk about the fumble by Yachty, which was Teenage Emotions, and now that the class of 2016 are all beginning to drop their debut albums, we are starting to get an idea of the artists who are here to stay and those who may not be around in another year or so. On one hand, you have someone like Kodak Black, who was able to deliver a great project and sold a solid 70,000 in his first week. And if he is able to stay out of trouble, it's likely we will see him stick around for another few years. And on the other hand, you have Lil Yachty, and in my video leading up to Teenage Emotions, I said that Yachty needed to come through with another Lil Boat caliber project to show and prove that he was in fact the king of the teens. And did he do that? Absolutely not. Although I thought the album was decent, the reception on the whole for the album has been very, very mixed. Groups like Young Thug and Lil Group for the most part have embraced the album, whereas if you look at my comments on my Flop or Not video or even Kanye Tither, the overwhelming support is for the opinion that it is utter trash and it's a flop quality wise. So it's clear that Yachty hasn't cemented himself as anything, rather his spot in this generation in light of the mixed reception for Teenage Emotions is undefined as ever. Adding to this are the poor sales of Teenage Emotions. Yachty only ended up selling 44,000, which honestly is a flop, no questions about it. This has left the void right open for Uzi to come in and cement his position in the game. So instead of Love Is Rage 2 competing with Teenage Emotions, really to be honest, Yachty is almost out of the discussion at this point, and it really is on Uzi whether he takes his spot or not. And regardless, either way, even if Uzi flops, Yachty isn't even up for this spot anymore. Secondly is a climate that Lil Uzi finds himself in right now. I really couldn't picture a better lead up to the release of his debut album, and for the sake of this video, we will assume that unlike the Perfect Love tape, Uzi won't release any singles beforehand. Obviously, the major song that stands out right now is EXO Tour Life, and at this point, there isn't really much I can say on this song and its enormity, but one thing I want to mention quickly is just how universal that song is. I think it's really the first song from the new generation to be loved by every hip-hop demographic. It really transcends the generational barrier that exists between the older generation and more youthful hip-hop music. And more so, even younger people who normally favor artists like Kendrick or Cole or what have you, and normally favor lyrics over catchy beats and melodies, find enjoyment in the confronting imagery that Uzi paints for the listener. So this song really reaches and pleases two different demographics that Uzi generally wouldn't have. And on top of this, the song is still gaining traction on radio, so expect the song to keep growing in the mainstream. Almost off the back of this song alone, it seems that Uzi's status within the game has skyrocketed and his respect from all types of hip-hop heads has risen. And secondly, adding to this is the other songs that were released for Love Is Rage 1.5. The plays on these songs are insane, and it shows that the hype he is getting from EXO Tour Life is spilling over into his other material. Even Boring Shit, which is one of the most least friendly songs of Uzi's in terms of catchiness, melodies, and what people generally look for in his music, is at 10 million plays. And this is a great sign. Even more so, the songs themselves are really, really good, and for me, a seasoned Lil Uzi fan, I see them as a strong return to form after that Gucci collab tape that was just a bit average, to be honest. On top of this is the amount that his name has been in the headlines, from his wardrobe choice controversies all the way to his epic jump at Coachella. Uzi's face and name has made all sorts of headlines and has made all sorts of memes, and although we know controversy and memes do not equal music quality or sales, it certainly doesn't hurt in any
publicity is good publicity. All these things combine to create the best climate and environment right now for Uzi to be dropping his debut album. He has the great music that is being received well by his fans. He has a huge hit EXO Tour Life that will end up being one of the biggest songs of the year. He has the controversies and moments that everybody is speaking about. And on top of that, his direct competition, Lil Yachty, kind of did a fumble and left the door right open for Uzi to come and take the spotlight that he had been in contention with Uzi for. So all in all, not a bad set of circumstances to be leading up to your debut album. And now for a couple more points specifically on Love Is Rage 2. I love that Uzi is taking his time on this project, and although I want it just as bad as everybody else, I appreciate the time and effort that seems to be going into this. I've seen people going at DJ Drama and Canon for taking too long with the mixing and mastering and whatnot, but I think it's a great thing, because specifically with Love Is Rage 1, the often dark vibes and sounds that came through on that project, like on 7am or Top or Paradise, and how that production worked and melded with Uzi's lethargic and relaxed voice was so intoxicating and immerse you into this other world, and I really can't compare those sounds to anything else coming out right now. Secondly is the snippets. Oh my fucking god, the snippets that are floating around for Love Is Rage 2, whether all of them will land on the album we don't know, but a lot of them have sounded fucking godly. From Alone Time to For Real to I Got The Work, Believe Me, Up The Ops, Firearm to Mess Up My Mood. If there is one snippet I could choose to be on Love Is Rage 2, it is Mess Up My Mood. Sounds fucking heavenly, and I can't tell you how many times I've played that snippet, and I could go on to name so many more. Uzi is sitting on so much heat right now, and every Lil Uzi fan seems to have their personal favorite snippet that they want to hear on Love Is Rage 2, and it's scary to think the type of music that'll be left off the album. I've been saying this ever since Uzi came out, and I said it in my video on him a couple months ago. Out of everybody who blew up in 2016, I think Uzi's got the juice to last, stay relevant, and keep growing. And so far, he has proven he can do that from mixtape to mixtape, but now it's time to cement himself with the debut album. Personally for me, Love Is Rage 1 has been my favourite Lil Uzi project to date, and I know a lot of fans feel the same way. So Uzi's put in a lot of pressure on himself to follow up what is considered a cult classic among Lil Uzi fans. But the combination of everything right now, from the 4 top tier songs that made up Love Is Rage 1.5, the sheer commercial success of EXO Tour Life, all the fucking fire snippets, all the headlines he's been making, and not to mention the time he is devoting to this project, I think Uzi will deliver a body of work that is up there with Love Is Rage 1, do huge numbers commercially, and will solidify himself as a leader of this new generation. Alright guys, that's all from me today, thanks a lot for watching. Make sure to let me know what you think about the video, and if you're keen for Love Is Rage 2 or not. Please like, subscribe, and follow me on all social medias for more.